Now, for the given problem, always student make mistake of considering y of n minus 1 as a part of cos of omega naught. Whereas, this is a constant coefficient which is associated with y of n minus 1. Second constant is b square. Here there is no constant, whereas here again there is one constant of b cos omega naught. So now we have three constant terms, which is one is 2b cos omega naught with y of n minus 1, minus b square and minus cos of b omega naught. So these are the three terms that we have now. So don't make mistake in analyzing the problem. That's why this problem is asked many times in paper. So student make mistake in analyzing this cos omega naught. Let us go ahead and solve the problem. As we see that the problem is given in the form of difference equation. So this is my difference equation. So as the problem is given in terms of difference equation, I need to first obtain h of z. So for the solution, step 1 will be obtain h of z. Now to obtain h of z, I need to apply z transform on the given problem. So y of n will be y of z 2b cos omega naught will be constant, will come out. Then y of minus 1, n minus 1 will be z inverse y of z minus b square, okay, z raised to minus 2 y of z plus x of z minus b cos omega naught z raised to minus 1 x of z, okay, taking all yz terms together and x of z terms together. So it will be yz, this will go that side, becomes minus 2b cos omega naught z inverse yz. This term when goes other side of the equal to sign becomes plus b square z raised to minus 2 y of z, which is all equal to x of z minus, okay, now this term I write over here as b cos omega naught z inverse x of z. So we have just rearranged the terms and have written in terms of y of z and x of z. Now let us take out y of z common, becomes y of z into 1 minus 2b cos omega naught z inverse, okay, again plus, okay, so plus b square z raised to minus 2. So this is the whole term with y of z, I have put the bracket by mistake, equals to, let's say xz, I pull it common, so it is 1 minus b cos omega naught into z raised to minus 1. Okay, so now this is x, y of z and x of z in terms of y of z and x of z we have received. Now let us take y of z upon x of z, which is nothing but h of z. So y of z upon x of z, so this term goes below, so 1 minus b cos omega naught z inverse upon 1 minus 2b cos omega naught z inverse plus b square z raised to minus 2. Okay, so now we got h of z in terms of numerator and denominator polynomial. So we see that this is my a 0, which is 1. This is my a 1, which is a whole constant. This is my b 0, the whole constant is B1, this is my B2. Okay, so now we got our transfer function and the constant. Let us draw the direct form 2 structure. So I will write my h of z again so that it will be at your sight. So h of z equals to 1 minus b cos omega naught z inverse divided by 1 minus 2b cos omega naught z inverse plus b square z raised to minus 2. Okay. Now, I'll write the constants. This is my A0, this is my A1, my B0, B1, B2. Okay. Let us draw the direct form 1 structure. Now, what is the highest degree of in the numerator polynomial or denominator polynomial? It is minus 2. Okay. So, I will draw direct form 2 structure over here also. And then I will draw direct form 1 structure also. So that the basic difference you can see easily, and then you can understand also the canonic form. So in direct form 2, we first draw string of z inverses. 1, 2, and 3. So we have 3 z inverses. Oh, not needed. Why to go for 3 z inverses? We should only have 2 z inverses. So I will eliminate this z inverse. This is not needed because there is no z raised to minus 3. There is only z raised to minus 2. Now, I will pull out adders on both the side of the structure. One on this side, on this side. Okay. Now, there is one more magic which I will show you. Okay, I am drawing a very crude level, just a basic block diagram on the basis of what we have understood about direct form 2. So, we will first draw a single string of z inverses, then we will pull out the arms from both the sides and draw the adders. Now, because the maximum degree is minus 2, I need to have 2 delay blocks. Okay, now. Based on B components will be going behind. So B components over here is, this is B1 and this is B2. So because I don't have much space over there, I write here, now this is minus B1. Okay, so there is a minus term associated with B1, so I will write over here as plus B1. So when I will write B1 equals, this B1 will be equal to, this is this B1. So I'll, this is not this one, okay. This B1 will be equal to 2B cos omega 0. Okay, because I need to flip the sign, and sign associated with B1 is minus. So when I write here, it will be flipped 1. So that flipped 1 will be positive. Whereas for B2 also I need to flip the sign. So I'll write minus B square. That is my B2. Okay. Because it is plus over here, I need to mention minus over here. And then I will connect the terms. So here this I will connect like this. And then I will have another plus sign over here and I will connect this also. Okay. And then I am going to get x of n at the input side, right? Now, on the other side, that is a forward going path. Forward going path, I will have your A0, A1, A2, right? Now, is there any z raised to minus 2 term in the numerator? No, there is no z raised to minus 2 term in the numerator. So will there be any output coming from z raised to minus 2? No, there will not be any requirement for this path because there is no z raised to minus 2. There is only z raised to minus 1 term in the given problem. So from z raised to minus 1, I will get A1. Now, A1 is having minus sign. So whoever goes in the forward direction will keep his sign as it is. So minus A1, so will be minus A1. So I will keep the sign as it is and I'll write as minus A1. Now your minus A1 stands for minus B cos omega naught. Okay, so I will not flip the sign when I'm writing A terms, and I will flip the sign when I'm writing the B terms. So this path is not needed. You don't need to actually bring out, and then this makes this term also redundant. So you can have just a node like this. Okay, so you can remove this also. There's no need. You can directly connect this over here to the addition sign because there are no two terms coming over here. Okay, so let me draw a very proper form so that it will be much more clearer to you. So I will draw here itself. So we will be drawing a string of Z inverse first. So there are only two. So that is Z inverse and Z inverse. Okay. Then in the denominator polynomial, I have Z raised to minus 2 terms. So there will be two hands coming out towards backwards or towards X of N. And in the numerator side, I have only one Z raised to minus 1 term. So only one line will come out, no line coming out from here. Then because I will have two signals coming over here, I will connect a adder block and I will connect this guy directly over here. And there is no other Z inverses. Otherwise, I would have an adder term here also. And there will be again two signals meeting at this point. One will be X of N, will be coming from here and the output will be there. So I will be having another adder block over here, and here I will have X of N. Okay, this will be going over here. And in the forward direction, I don't need any adder block over here because nothing is going to come from here this side. So I will have only one adder block here and I will connect this to this guy. Now again, here this will be 1, this will be 1, and this will be y of n. Okay, now whoever goes behind will flip the sign. Here after z, along with z raised to minus 2, I have b2, which will be minus b square. So I will be write minus b square. Here along with z1, I have minus 2b, so I'll write plus 2b cos omega 0. Okay, forward direction with Z inverse, I have minus, so I'll write minus B cos omega 0. Okay, so that is what the complete direct form to structure is. Now we have finally reached a direct form to structure. Now let us just see that if I would have made a direct form 1 structure, how different it would look and how many delay blocks it will require. It is just to show that how many delay blocks direct form 1 requires. In exam, it is not mandatory. If it is asked to draw only direct form 2, you should not draw direct form 1. But if suppose they have asked draw direct form 1 and 2 of the given difference equation, then you have to draw both. But here I am just drawing to clear the concept that how direct form 1 is different than direct form 2. For direct form 1, I will have two separate strings of Z inverse. For the numerator, there is only one Z inverse. For the denominator, I will have two Z inverses. Okay. Now, from the numerator side, one adder block will be required here, and this coefficient is minus b cos omega naught. Now from the denominator side, there are two coefficients. Here it is minus b square and here it is, I'll draw an adder over here so that becomes clear picture. Here it is minus b cos omega 0. Okay, then here goes addition, this over here and this goes over here, and here is my x of n which comes in, this is my y of n which goes out. So if you can compare both the structures, let us compare both the structures. So if you can compare both the structure, here we see that we require only two delay block where the degree of the denominator polynomial was 2, okay, whereas in direct form 1 we required 3 delay block, 1 for the numerator and 2 for the denominator, say. So as you can see that the number of delay blocks not equal to the degree of h of z. I would have written highest degree of h of z. It might be in the numerator degree or the denominator degree, whichever is the highest that you have to consider, is not equal to the highest degree of h of z. This structure cannot be called as the canonic structure. Whereas direct form 2, the number of delay block is equal to the degree of the polynomial, hence they are called as the canonic structure. So this is how the direct form 2 is beneficial over direct form 1. So this is how the overall process to design or draw or create a realization of direct form 2. Thank you.